Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel guys. So guys, today I'll be sharing this Indian glam makeup look which has got glitter, half cut crease, color, everything in one. Actually I've got a lot of new makeup to try and I thought why not to create an Indian glam makeup look because Diwali is really near. So I created this makeup look using all of the new makeup that I've got. This video is definitely going to be a long one, so get yourself comfortable. If you are going out somewhere, so get your makeup on and get glam with me. If you would like to know that how I created this look using all of the new makeup that I've got, then please keep on watching. But before I begin, make sure that you do subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed yet. Hit the notification bell next to it so that you don't miss out on any of my future uploads. And yes, with that being said, let's just begin this video. So I was not kidding when I said first impression. Not all the products are from Nykaa, by the way. Only few of them I have used it, or maybe I have swatched it. For my moisturizer, I have got this pack moisturizer. It's called Pack Moisture Lotion. Actually, I ordered the moisture spray. I think that was the name of the product, and they deliver me this product. It's like a body lotion or something. It's a big bottle, guys. For 750, I think it's a good steal. By the time I'll be done with this video, there will be a lot of mess around me with the boxes and everything. It's very light. I don't like thick moisturizer, by the way. I really like it. It's not too sticky and not too oily. It is definitely very watery, and I love the water-based moisturizers. If you know me, you know I'm gonna color correct as usual. So the first one I have right here is from Becca, and this is their under eye brightening corrector. This is in the shade medium to deep. Another concealer which I have here with me is from Miss Claire. It's their full coverage makeup, and this is in the shade 17. I think I'm gonna use the Becca under eye brightening corrector. I'm gonna take it with a brush. It's very creamy. It's not too thick. I'm gonna blend it with the same brush. I'm gonna apply it around my mouth as well. This is very light for my liking, but I think I'm gonna use my foundation first. I'm sorry, that was my foot. And then I'm gonna say that whether I like this or not. So for my foundation, I'm gonna use Fenty Beauty's Pro Filter Soft Matte Longwear Foundation. I got it in the shade 310. I think I'll need one more. So I've taken 3 pumps in total. I'm gonna blend it with the help of my beauty blender. So I have just dipped my beauty blender once, and you can see it has already covered everything on this side of my face, and I love the finish. It's definitely full coverage, and it has covered my dark circles. It is not looking grey anymore. I love it. I've already spoken about this onto my Instagram before, that it does survive the heat as well. I'm gonna apply a little bit of lip balm because my lips are looking really dead. If you guys sweat a lot and if you haven't got around to try this foundation, definitely give it a shot. You might love it. And they have got bunch of shades in this range, so I think definitely you will get your shade. I'm back with my eyebrows on, and to set my eyebrows in place, I'm gonna use my 24-hour brow setter from Benefit. I think it's a invisible gel. Okay, I love the wand of this product. It is definitely getting into each of the hair of my eyebrows. I think I'm gonna replace this with my beads. I'm gonna use it a few more times to give my final verdict. I want to see that how it lasts for the longest, because my clear brow gel doesn't make my eyebrows bulge for the whole day, even in water. So that's a big claim. I'm gonna use eyeshadow crayon as my eyeshadow primer today. This is from Sephora in the shade Secret Boudoir. I got this when I went to Singapore, and the lady over there suggested me, and then I suddenly remembered that Kaushal uses this a lot on her channel. It was affordable. I think it was for 750 rupees something. Definitely try first on one eye and then on the other, because this sets very quickly. So I've got two palettes right here to try. Tarte High Performance Naturals Rainforest of the Sea Foil Finger Paints Shadow Palette. I was trying to show you guys and the whole thing just came off. I love the feel of this palette, and it definitely matches my dress. Three shades and two glitters as your eyeshadow toppers. I love this. Ultimate Basics eyeshadow palette has also got a brush with it, which has just fallen. First, I'm using the shade Faith. Onto the eyes, these shades are definitely looking a lot darker. So I'm using the shade Commando just to tone this shade down a bit, because right now it's looking a little too dark for my liking. I'm going to only use the shade Extra Bitter just to give a little bit of warmth to my eyes with a small brush. This is pack 126. I'm just applying it onto the exact crease area. I'm taking a clean brush. I'm gonna first blend this and then we're gonna make it more vibrant. So far I'm not seeing any fallout under my eyes. I'm loving it. I'm taking the shade Lock Out and applying it just onto the outer corners of my eyes to make it little bit more defined. Blending brush, and I'm gonna soft everything up. I'm gonna attempt to do a half cut crease, not too major, very soft. I'm gonna use Urban Decay's All Nighter Full Coverage Concealer. I'm gonna take a little bit onto the back of my hand. I like to keep my mirror like this so I can exactly see where my crease is. So yeah, it's a little tip if you are struggling. I'm gonna use the shade Nudie and set this concealer in place. And I'm gonna do the same thing onto the other eyes, and I will be back because my battery is draining. I'm gonna use a little bit of Lockout shade one more time and applying it onto the outer edge of my eyes. Just creating a dimension so that it doesn't look a line over there. So I'm gonna take a little bit of the shade Extra Bitter. So where I have cut the crease, I'm applying the Extra Bitter shade over there so that it merges everything and bring the look together. I'm taking the Faith shade again. It's an end step for making the whole look come together. I'm going to take the shade Gold Coast. Ooh, this is definitely very pretty. I think I'm going to use it for Diwali for sure. I'm also bringing it to highlight the inner corners of my eyes with the same eyeshadow because it's so hard to resist. This is very pretty. So I'm not gonna wing it out because I have already created the illusion of wings itself. So my battery died and I was almost sitting for 40 minutes lounging. I really need to invest in new battery for sure. So I've got two variety of glitters to choose from. They both look exactly similar when applied onto the eyes because I've tried it and I was shook. So I thought of sharing it with you. So this is Miss Claire's Pearl Eyeliner. This is in the number 16. This is Urban Decay's Midnight Cowboy. Miss Claire's Pearl Eyeliner, and this is Urban Decay's Heavy Metal Glitter Liner. They look very similar. We're gonna go with the affordable option. Really love this product already. Highly recommend it. If you guys get around to try this product, definitely give it a shot. This is L'Oreal's False Lash Superstar Mascara. It has got primer on one end and a mascara on the other. Maybelline The Colossal Big Shot Mascara. I'm gonna try this mascara today. The problem is that this is not waterproof. I generally go for waterproof mascara because I've got watery eyes. I didn't like it that much. It's not even giving me that much of lengthening. I think I'll pass on to this product. I have got this Plum Nature Studio All Day Wear Cold Kajal. So from this pack, I got this sharpener and the kajal. I love the sharpener actually. Let me try it on the back of my hand. Okay, it is very smooth. I'm not gonna apply it on my waterline because I'm gonna use a colored liner. Showed you both of these concealer in my last collective makeup haul. This is Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define. This is in the shade C12. I've also got Wet n Wild's Photo Focus Concealer. This is in the shade Medium Deep 10. And the last one which I have is Urban Decay's All Nighter, which I used it onto my eyes for creating this cut crease look, and this is in the shade Medium Dark Neutral. I think I'm gonna try Wet n Wild Photo Focus because I have not used it yet. This is very dark, you guys. It is never going to give me any brightening effect. So to set my concealer in place, I'm going to use Maybelline's Fit Me Loose Setting Powder. It's loose finishing powder. I've got it in the shade 25 medium. It makes click sound. I think it's better packaging than my Laura Mercier setting powder. impressed with the packaging. Sorry, I forgot that I wanted to do cream contouring today. The shade adjusting drops by the Body Shop. This retails for $17.95 for 15 ml of the product, but these are very concentrated. These are generally used for darkening your foundation, so I think I can use it both ways. I have taken just one pump. Okay, so first impression, loved it. It blended out so easily. I didn't need to take extra effort to blend it, and it didn't even, you know, moved my foundation around. So I have taken a little bit. My concealer didn't brighten my under eyes, but my powder did. So we are saved. Guys, this powder is very smooth. I'm not baking, I'm just setting my concealer because I don't have anywhere to go today. So I don't have any new contour powder, so I'm going to use my Freedom's Pro Stroke palette, and I'm going to use a mixture of both of these shades to set my contour in place. For my bronzer today, I'm going to use Benefit's Hoola, and this is the brush which comes with it. I've used it only once. I love this bronzer a lot. I'm gonna use my L'Oreal Infallible Blush Paint. I shared this in my September favorites video. Click I up here so that you can see my September favorites if you haven't seen it. I'm gonna use the mixture of both of these shades. This is a little bit shimmery. It is very pigmented. A little goes a long way. Guys, these blushes have like chocolatey, fruity, chocolatey fragrance to it. Love it. I haven't smelled it before, I think. I smelled it for the first time. So on my waterline, I'm not going to use a black liner. I'm going to use this Rimmel Exaggerate Waterproof Eye Definer. And this is in the shade Emerald Spark. It's a retractable eyeliner, and I love it because it's very handy dandy when it comes to traveling. It has also got a smudger on the back if you want to smudge it out. As you can see, it has got a sparkle in it. I really, really love it. I'm going to use the Faces Glam on Color Perfect Eyeshadow, and this is in the variant Fascinate 02. Help of pencil brush, I'm going to apply it. So definitely set your eyeliner, even if it is black, set it so that it will last for long and it won't smudge under your eyes. So I'm going to use Huda Beauty Samantha Lashes on my lashes today. My lower lash mascara. I'm going to use the Maybelline The Colossal Big Shot Volume Express Mascara. I'm going to apply this off camera and get back to you guys. So to set my makeup in place, I have recently got this PAC Microfinish Makeup Fixer. It was so nice. Loved it. Aerosol spray they have gotten, this is amazing. So I can see that it has not left any droplets onto my face. It has dispersed so evenly. I feel that I have actually drenched my face in a bowl of water. For 850 rupees, you are getting 120 ml of the product. It's a way lot of product, guys. I have got Fair Shimmering Powder from Sephora, and this is in the variant Delicate Glow. Again, if you haven't watched my Follow Me to Sephora vlog and the Sephora haul, click I up here and see that if you want to see what all I have picked up. So I love the embossed print you get in this product. It is so pretty. It looks like a snake skin. I'm gonna use this Zoeva's 134 Luxe Powder Fusion Brush. It has no kickback. Guys, I haven't wet my brush, and you can see this is so pretty. So pretty. So I'm going to use the same highlighter to highlight my brow bone. I'm going to use my setting spray one more time just to make everything look soft and smooth. Also got one new lip liner. This is from LA Girl, and this is in the shade P543 Cafe. Right now I'm not feeling it very smooth. Let's see how it goes. So I've got two lipsticks right here. NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade Toulouse. And I have also got this Lakme Absolute Matte Melt Liquid Lip Color. And this is in the shade 07 Mild Mauve. So I think I'm gonna go with the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream. So far I am living for this look. Now let me do my hair and exercise a little bit and get back to you. So I'm back and I did my hair. I'm wearing earrings and I'm also wearing bindi. Look little bit Diwali appropriate. I have to glam up a little bit. So yes, I really hope that you have enjoyed this video, guys. So I have actually collected everything in this bag so that I can give you a roundup of every product that I used. I love the moisturizer, highly recommend. Becca Corrector. I'm not too sure about this product. I do have to give few more tries. Fenty Beauty Foundation, loved it. Highly recommended. I do have to give few more tries. First impression, if you ask me, I loved it. I love this cream contour. It's very easy to blend. I loved it. Do not give a second thought to it. If you can get it from Sephora, definitely buy it. It's affordable. It's not that expensive. Out of all of these products, definitely give it a shot to this pearl eyeliner from Miss Claire. You won't regret it. Look at me. It is looking so sparkly and so glamorous, and in person it's looking very very pretty. Definitely buy this. I don't know yet because I have to let this makeup sit onto my face for long so that I can actually tell you guys that whether I love it or not. Highly recommend Benefit's Hoola bronzer, best bronzer out there. This Diwali, I'm definitely carrying this palette with me. Love it for my crease. Highly recommend it. I don't like this mascara. Do not recommend it. So this eyeshadow crayon from Sephora, I was told that they are going to discontinue this product. So if you can get your hands on this product, definitely give it a shot. I have to try a few more times this kajal. Then only I'll be able to recommend it to you. And this mascara from L'Oreal, I don't know how do I feel about it. And it's not waterproof, so I don't think I'll be using it that much. And by the way, all the products will be linked in the description box, so check the description box, guys. And the lipstick which I have used from NYX, loved it. And this shade is also very very pretty. And this setting spray which I used, highly recommended. I also reduced all the powderiness onto my face and it smells amazing. Even the aerosol spray, loved it. And also this brush which I used for my highlighter, loved it. It's very fluffy, it's very soft. I only use one eyeshadow from this Tarte palette and I really like it, guys. I cannot wait to play with this palette more. It almost feels like wet eyeshadow onto your eyes. So this is it, guys. I'm sorry for this longest video, but I really hope that you enjoyed this video and you also found new products to try and add into your vanity. If you have any new video ideas for Diwali, let me know in the comment section. And make sure that you do subscribe. Do not miss on subscribing. And yes, with that being said, I'll see you very very soon in my next video, guys. Bye.